So guys, you are most welcome again in the second lecture of previous year question series. So in this lecture series, we are going to solve all two marker from organic chemistry December 2015. So without wasting time, let's start with the topic. So the first question is, the major product formed in the following reaction is, in this case what you can see here, we have been given the COCl2, right? So what we can do, C double bond O and C double bond O, Cl and Cl. And also we have been given DMSO. So here we will have methyl and here again methyl, like this. So we will have something like this, and what, and sulfur oxide O minus we will have, right? So here we will have O minus and sulfur will contain positive charge like this. So this O minus which we have, that will attack on this one. So that is just like the Swan oxidation reaction. But in this case, one thing you can observe is, we are not going to use any base, right? So if we are not going to use any base, so our product, whatever we are going to get, that may be affected. Otherwise, what happens, without looking at the option and without going with the mechanism, you will say that this first could be the correct answer, right? So this first can be the correct answer. Yeah, fine. Because in the Swan oxidation, what happens here, we have once we have this alcohol, so that get converted into the aldehyde or the ketone, like that. But here the mechanism will be little different one. So this will attack over here, and what will happen, this will become O minus, and once again it will come back. So Cl minus will be removed from here. So once the Cl minus will be removed from here, so that Cl minus, that Cl minus, that can again attack on this S, right? So that can again attack on this S, and what we are going to get is, actually in this case, so we will have S, and here two methyls are connected over here, and apart from this, what we will have, and this S which is present over here, so oxygen, and this oxygen is connected with this carbon, so C double bond O and C double bond O Cl, like this. So we will have something like this, right? And after the attacking with the Cl, here positive charge we will have. So once the Cl minus will attack on this one, so this will get removed from here. So once this will get removed from here, so what is going to happen in this case? So here what I am going to get is S. Here what we will have is 2 methyl and positive charge, and Cl we will have like this, right? And we are going to have something like this, and this bond will break like this. And after this, what can happen? Once this bond will break, and this oxygen will become minus, and this will again come back, and once again it will come back. So what is going to happen? So here this bond can break, right? Once this bond will break, so this will remove as CO. So again this will go over here, again this will come back, and Cl minus will be removed from here. So here it will become COCl, sorry, not COCl, plus CO plus CO2 plus Cl minus. This Cl minus will also be removed from here. So in this process we are going to get this one. So once we will have this one, so what is going to happen in the next step? So here let's see, here we had this one, right? So here we have something like this. So once we have something like this, and here we have S positive charge, and this methyl, and this methyl, and Cl we have. So the electron pair of this oxygen can attack on this one, just like this one oxidation. But the difference is what? In this step, in this coming step, we are going to use the base. But here in this case, we are not using the base. But instead of base, we have only this Cl minus. So once it will come back at this position, attack at this position, so what is going to happen? Here the product formed will be something like this. So this oxygen S, and here what we will have is 2 methyl, right? And this Cl will remove from here. And here this sulfur will have positive charge. So the Cl minus which we have is, the Cl minus, sorry, here we have 1 methyl as well, CH2 is present over here. So this Cl minus can attack at this position. So once this will attack at this position, so what is going to happen? This bond can break. So the product, what we are going to get is only this one. So here we have the Cl. So you can see the difference if we use the base. So in that case, we are getting this product. But if you are not using the base and the reaction is at very low temperature, so in that case, the product will be this one. So the fourth option will be the correct one, right? I hope you understood up to this much. Now the next problem we have is, here we have this compound, and after this what we are going to do over here, here we have two hydrogens, and these two hydrogens are acidic one. So the base which we have over here, NaOMe, so this will abstract the proton from here. So once it will abstract the proton, so here we are going to get negative charge. So something like this we will have, double bond O, and here, here we will have negative charge. It won't be over here, right? So after this, what is going to happen? Sorry, yeah, Br will be at this position. Br will remain as it is because this is the hydrogen which is abstracted by this base. So this negative can attack on this one, and this Br will be removed from here. So just like the NGP, right, neighboring group participation. So this will become something like this here, double bond O, and here we have one Br, and something like this. So this is what we will have. After this, what is going to happen? So once we have something like this, so again this base which we have is OME minus, so that can again attack at this carbonyl center because this is the electrophilic center, and after this here it will become O minus and it will become OME, and rest will remain as it is, right? After this step, what is going to happen? So once you got this much, again this negative charge will shift over here. So once this negative charge will shift over here, so this bond will break like this. So this bond will break like this. And once this bond will break, so here what is going to happen? And once this bond will break, so Br will also get removed from here. So in this case, double bond and here, sorry, two methyls and here double bond will come of this one. And apart from this, so this will connected with over here and the ester. So here what we are going to get is, so after this double bond, we have this one. And here this is connected with C double bond O and this as OME. So can we see any option like this? CO2, yes. In the third one we can see like this, right? So in the third one we can see like this. So this is the reason why we will have this third as the correct option, right? Now let's move to the next question. The question is this one: the major product formed in the following reaction is. So what is going to happen in this case? Here this question we have already studied in the carbene, right? If you haven't studied the reactive intermediate, go and watch that all the videos and you will be able to solve this question. In this case, if you have this N2, so this is not just N2, so it is like N double bond N, and here it has positive charge and here it has negative charge like this. So after this, what happens? So this negative charge shift over here, and what happens? So this double bond which you can see over here, actually this shift over here. Once we use a catalyst like this, what happens? Actually the carbenoid formation takes place. So the here carbene formation will take place at this position. So here we will have OBN, and here two groups will be connected with this one and double bond, and here the carbene will be formed at this place, right? So once the carbene will be formed, so after that what can happen? So in the same compound you can see that here we have OBN. BN means benzyl, means CH2, and here phenyl ring, right? So here we have something like this. I am writing it OCH2 and here phenyl ring. So this oxygen actually can attack on this carbene. So once it will attack on this carbene, so what is going to happen? I should write it in a proper manner. I can write it like this. Here double bond, I can write double bond O, and here we have this carbene, and after this we have this oxygen and this CH2 and this pH like this. So once it will attack at this position, so the cyclization will take place. So in cyclization process, what is going to happen? Let's see. Here to like this double bond, and here we have something like this. And this oxygen will have positive charge and CH2 and pH, and here negative charge will come. Now in the option, you can see that in these two options, actually this is not present, right? So once this is not present, so you can neglect these two options. So we have these two options only. But in this case also, what you can see over here, actually this benzyl group which we have over here, that can migrate to this position. The reason why it will migrate, because what happens, actually this oxygen, if you will see, so this has already positive charge. So this definitely want to lose this group. So once this will lose this bond, so what will going to happen? Again, it will go back in the reverse reaction. So it will definitely lose this benzyl. So once this will lose this benzyl, so what is going to happen? Actually, so this will abstract this benzyl group, and benzyl group will migrate at this position, right? Like insertion reaction. So this will come over here and the product formed will be a benzyl just next to this carbonyl group. So in the benzyl, you can see this second option. In the second option, we have this. This will be the correct one. We have already solved this question in the reactive intermediates, right? If you want to clear all your concepts, so you can go and watch those videos. Now after this, we have something like this. Now let's see what will happen in this case. Here, if you have this such kind of compound, right? So in this case, what happens actually? Here in this case, the major product formed in the following reaction is, here in the first step, what we have is NBu3SNH tributyl tin hydride, and we have used a AIBN, right? And benzene is also present in this case, right? So what will happen in this case? Here if you will try to write down the structure, in this case actually, here we have been, here this double bond is present, and here we have this OOET, and like this, and this is present, and this compound, and this compound. Actually this is little complicated one. The reason why this is little complicated, you have used the tin hydride, right, and AIBN. So what is going to happen? The reaction will proceed just to the radical reaction. So once the reaction will proceed via the radical reaction, so what is going to happen in this case? Actually the reaction will be little complicated one. And here in this case, this is this double bond which you can see over here. Actually this should break, and once this will break, so in that case what is going to happen? Here we have seed oxygen, right, CH2, and then followed by this oxygen, and here we have this OET, right? And once we have this OET, actually the reaction is little complicated one. So in this case what will happen? Actually this bond will break, right, homolytic fission will take place. So once this will break from here, and after this what is going to happen? Once this will break, so radical formation, actually this CH2 and oxygen and this double bond O which is over here, actually this will be get oxidized using this Jones reagent, right? So this, once this will get oxidized using the Jones reagent, so in that case it will become double bond O, right? So it will become double bond O like this, and after that what happens? The cyclization will take place, and overall in this cyclization the product formed will be this first one, right? So reaction is very much complicated, and if I try to write down, so actually the video will become very much longer, and in the photochemistry we will try to discuss this example, and this is quite the difficult kind of question which we say asked in the exam, right? So this first will be the correct option in this case. Now let's see the next one. The major product formed A and B in the following reaction. So now how you can solve this one? So you have been given this one, and you can find these all kind of question in the research paper, right? And what will happen if you will try to Google this question? So definitely you can find out its answer and mechanism and so many things related to this and all, because this is the example of actually cope elimination reaction, right? To understand this cope elimination reaction, you should study the pericyclic reaction very well. If you have studied the pericyclic reaction very well, so in that case you can definitely solve this one. So if you have this 6-membered ring, so first of all try to write out in the chair form. So if I try to write down in the chair form, so how I can do this? Actually this like this, and like this, and here we have this N which is what, which is just above the plane. So one, if I'm writing for this first one, not with this second one, if this is N is above the plane, so in that case what will happen? Actually if I write at this position, so this will become N, and here it will become O minus, and this 2 methyl group, right? And just next to N we have this methyl which is below the this group which is below the plane. So if this is below the plane, so how I can write this? So I can write it like this, right? Write it like this, and I can write like this. And after this, so here what we will have is here one hydrogen, and here one hydrogen, and here methyl group, and here this hydrogen like this, here this hydrogen, right? So once you are hitting this, so in this case what happens, actually this is the example of scope elimination. So an oxide, what happens, it abstract the proton from its adjacent carbon. So it will abstract this proton, and once it will abstract this proton, so this will shift over there, this bond will shift and this bond will break. So double bond will be formed in this case. So if I try to write down the product in this case, actually that will be like this, here double bond, and rest of the things will be like this, here methyl we will have, and here we will have like this. So rest everything will be same, and if I try to convert into the six membered, so like this, if I put double bond over here, so after this we have this methyl which was above the plane, so this will remain as it is above the plane, and this was below the plane. So this is the product what we are going to get. It is a kind of syn elimination, right? So if this is syn elimination, so both the groups, so which are leaving, that should be on the same side. Now let's go for this next one, and if I try to write down the structure for this one, so in that case what will happen? Like this, and here, and what we have is, that is here it was above the plane, now this is below the plane. So N, and here what we will have, O minus, two groups and positive charge, right? And the rest things are same. And here what we have is methyl group, and here two group, like this. Again what will happen, again this hydrogen, again syn elimination, right? So this hydrogen will be abstracted and the double bond will be formed like this, and again the product what we are going to get is the same product, right? So what we will have is like this, and same product we will have. If I try to convert this and this, so they both are same. So in this case can we observe, yeah, C will be the correct option, right? So C is the correct option over here. Now let's go for the next one. The next question is, D mannose upon refluxing in acetone with copper sulfate and H2SO4 gives. And this question is an example of protection of diol, because acetone has been given using acetone, right? So what will happen, the hydrogens which the OH groups which are on the same side, so accept this anomeric oxygen, so the oxygen which are on the same side, so they both will get protected using this ketone. So these two which you can see over here, these both will get protected, right, in the carboxylic acid and the protection. After studying these two chapter, protection and deprotection and the carboxylic acid, you will be able to solve this question. So these two H which are on the same side, so in that case the acetone will combine with this, and that is the kind of protection. And once you hit this one, the six membered with the CuSO4 and H2SO4, if you hit this, so this six membered get converted into the five membered. So here this six membered will get converted into the five membered like this. So either these or this can be the correct option. But here in this case, the anomeric oxygen is affected, right? But here in this case, this is not affected. So this will be the correct option because it won't be affected, right? It won't be affected. Now let's go for the next question, which is the major product formed by the photochemical reaction of 2E4Z6E decatriene, right? And the first thing which you have to do is you have to write down the structure of this decatriene. Now let's see how you can draw. So if you go for the decatriene, so how you can draw the structure? So I can write like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this complete already 6, right? Because 2E, 4Z and 6E, right? So this is 1, 2E, right? And 3, 4, 4Z and 5 and 6 E. E means that will be like this. 6, 7, 7, it will become 7, 8, 9, 9, 10. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like this. After this, what will happen? Let's see. Here we have this hydrogen and this hydrogen. So this is just like what we are going to do, photochemical reaction, H nu, right? So this is 4 plus 4 pi plus 2 system, 4 plus 2 pi system, right? So in this case, what is going to happen? Actually, if you will see in the 4n plus 2 system, in photochemical condition, the con rotation takes place. So once the con rotation will take place, so the hydrogen which are on this plane, right? So these hydrogen, which is actually the group which is on the plane, if I try to do the con rotation, so in that case, the group which is present over here, that will come above the plane, right? So that will come above the plane because this is in the plane. So once you are rotating, so that will come above the plane like this, and this hydrogen which is present over here, so that one hydrogen will also come above the plane and one hydrogen will also go below the plane like this, right? So in this case, the six membered will be formed like this. Six membered compound will be formed like this, and try to imagine this one, and here one hydrogen this was 2E, right? So here this would be, one should be methyl, so 1, 2, and this would be 3, and this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and this won't be over here because at 2 position we have E like this. After this, at 4 we have Z, right? These two groups are on the same side, and at the 6 position we have E like this. So here we will have one methyl, so methyl will go below the plane and this group will come above the plane, right? So this will come above the plane like this. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, correct. So in the option, is it given? Yeah, the first A will be the correct option over here. I hope you are getting it. Now let's go for the next one. The next question is, the correct statement about the following reaction is that, if you have watched the reactor intermediate videos, you can just solve in the fraction of second even. Now, what will happen in this case? Here you have been given this H nu and this MeOH, and here the carbene formation will take place and the carbene will be formed at this position, right? And once the carbene will be formed at this position, and here we have given this one, and after this what can happen? The actually ketene formation will take place, and how this ketene? Actually this group which is present over here, that will migrate to this one, and here in this case you are going to get something like this, right? And after this, what is going to happen? Here double bond C and double bond O like this, and after this you have been given MeOH. So what is going to happen in this case? Actually they both will be MeOH. So this MeO minus will come and attack at this position. So the product formed will be C double bond O O M E. Like this. So this, either this or this can be the product. So A will be correct option because carbene is the correct one. Now let's go for the next one, which is the structure of compound that matches the 1H NMR data of the given below. Like you have been given this 3 to 5. First of all, to solve this question, actually you should go for the number of protons which are present. So if I go for the number of protons, so here 5 data has been given. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this case, 5 different protons are available. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this case also it's available. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this case also it's available. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can't differentiate, right? You can't neglect any option. Now you have to go for the coupling and this like J value, right? Coupling constant and the number of protons which are present over here. So now what happens if I go with this one? So how you can predict and what will be the correct structure over here? If I go with this one, so what will happen? Here we have one hydrogen and the J value is 8.8, right? 8.8 value indicates what? This 8.8 which is present over here. This indicates meta ortho coupling, right? So here we have one meta ortho coupling, and apart from this, actually if you will see, so here one hydrogen present over here and we have been given this one, right? Now let's see how we can predict. So in the meta ortho coupling, so in the meta position, if I talk, so here 1, 2, 3, so this is the meta position of this one, right? If I talk about this hydrogen, right? So this meta ortho coupling, meta here it is ortho and here it is meta, right? So meta and ortho both couplings are present over here. And now let's go for the next data, which is 7.58, right? So this is 7.58 and this is 7.75. So these two protons which you can see over here, actually they have delta value little higher. So once they have delta value little higher, so it means that they are present just next to the electron withdrawing group. So in this case, if I go with this one and this one and this one, in this case even, if you will try to find out, so here these two hydrogens which are present over here, actually they should have the value this in this range, 7.75 and 7.70, like this, right? So these two protons should have values in this range only. Otherwise, here if I go with this one and this one, so in this case it won't have and it also won't have, and here it will have this much value, right? Because they are highly deshielded. Now after this, if I go with this one, 6.70 and 6.50 and 3.80, so this 3.80 which is present over here, actually this should be the value of this methyl OME, right? So OME which is present over here, because this is giving singlet and three hydrogens, so this will have 3.80 value. And here two hydrogens broad means two hydrogens 6.50. This one, you can only, this is the only way you can differentiate. And if I go with this one, 6.70 and doublet and one proton, 6.70. So here we have this hydrogen which will have value 6.70, like this. Here, so this should be the correct option, because what is the reason? First reason is actually J value is 8.8, and here what is going to happen? Meta ortho coupling. So ortho and meta coupling is present over here. And the second thing, if you will go with the delta value, so in the delta value range, what you can see, actually here these two have the high value. So once they have the high value, they should be present just next to the electron withdrawing group, just like NO2 and all, right? So in that case, so this will be the correct option. So B will be the correct option. Now the next question, the 10th one, the correct match structure, and you have to find out the value of IR. So if you have been given this lactone, so once you have the lactone, so in that case here this will be double bond O. So once you have the lactone, so in that case, this is not double bond O, this should be like this is the lactone, right? Cyclic esters are called as lactone. So once you have this structure, so you have to remember this one, this has value 1770. So means P will have Y. So PY, and either this first one or this second one can be the correct one. Now you have to differentiate which will be the correct. In this case, if you go with this R, so because the conjugation is present, so that's why it will have the low value. So it means that it will have 1750 value. So R will have X. So A first will be the correct option, and this, because here don't have any conjugation, so it will have little higher I value of IR, so it will have this one. Now in this case, the number of chemical shift non-equal